Let's talk about dominant chords this time. A very short lesson about dominant chords, actually about the fifth degree in a tonality. A fifth degree is a dominant chord that resolves back to the tonality. So when you talk about F major as a tonality, the fifth degree is a C7. And the scale that you play over the C7 chord is just the same as F major, but you emphasis the C and the E and the G and the B flat. And actually you want to skip or play the F on a upbeat. The F is actually a note that you don't want to hear on a downbeat. All right, so this is the chord. And I play a scale down. That's C7. And then the scale down from C to C. That's the same as F major. And the scale is actually called F major. I don't want to use modal scales like Mixolydian just for a degree in F. C belongs to F, it resolves to F, so let's use F and we emphasize other notes other than F. All right, how do you use that scale? Because it's seven notes and seven notes don't fit a regular 4-4 bar or a 3-4 bar, right? So you have to come up with eight notes or six notes, and in this case eight notes is the best. I count off 3, 4. Doesn't fit. So if you add a chromatic note, it should be a chromatic note that doesn't change the function of the dominant chord, right? So, for instance, between the 8 and the 7 octave and the dominant 7, you can play a chromatic note. So in time, 3, 4. And the notes that you play on the downbeat are the notes of the basic C7 chord. So this is a very simple and very basic form of the fifth degree in F. If you have, for instance, C7 13, that's the 6, and that's an A, you can also play that chromatic note between the 6 and the 5. And then you play the 6 on the downbeat. Right? So this is the very basic form of a C7 chord. And the scale is F major with one chromatic note. All right. The interesting thing about dominant chords is that they have extensions or alterations. That means that the 9, for instance, or the 13, or the 11 can be changed, but the function stays the same. And most of the times the tonality also stays the same. So there's one extension that can be changed. That's the 9. So you have, instead of C7, 9, 13, which sounds like this, you have C7, flat 9, 13. And no other extensions or alterations yet. So this is 9, 13, and that's gonna be like this. There's a nice upper structure triad of A major that you can put on top of C7. Anyway, the scale that you can play now is the same as we did before, but all the D's are D flats. All the 9's are flat 9's. That's the normal scale. Before we play any chromatic notes, think about the name of this scale. And the name is F major harmonic because of the flat 6 of F. That scale from C to C sounds like this. Alright, now we think about 8 notes again to put this scale back in the 4-4 or the 3-4 bar. Just use the same grammatics as we did before. Or. So this is C7 flat 9-13. It's good, by the way, to practice it in time, yeah? To play over a C7 flat 9-13 in a very natural way. Think about F as a tonality, F major harmonic, with emphasis C7 flat 9. 1, 2. Etc. All right. Suppose this flat 9-13 has also a sharp 11. C7 flat 9-13, sharp 11. Sharp 11 is the F sharp. It's the tritone of C7. Very nice alteration. And then the arpeggio sounds like this. Right, now it gets interesting because we have to come up with a scale including the F sharp, but the tonality is F, so this is going to be difficult. And the scale that you play is this one. Comes from C7. In order to fill in the E and the D flat, you can play also an E flat. E flat is a sharp 9 or a flat 10 actually. You have a flat 9 and you have a flat 10. Comes together. So this is the scale. This scale has already 8 notes and therefore it's called octatonic scale. The octatonic scale doesn't have anything to do with one particular tonality. So it's not, we're not talking about only about F major anymore. And this scale is very good to use, for instance, motifs. That's it, right? Motifs like that. So practice an octatonic scale in thirds. And if you have difficulties playing octatonic, you can think about C7 down and F sharp 7 down. That's the tritone. That's octatonic. All right. But again, octatonic doesn't have anything to do with only one tonality. Where are we? C7 9 flat 13. And the flat 13 is an A flat. So this is it. And this chord, before the bebop, it was used quite often actually. Armstrong. Yeah. Combined with an F6 instead of an F major 7. Alright, the scale that you play over this is the same as F, but then every A is gonna be an A flat. And the name of that scale is F minor melodic. C9 flat 13. Where are the grammatics? Same spot. Between the 8 and the 7. Alright, sometimes, and especially in the handwritten real book, it says C9 plus or C7 plus, and plus means plus 5. The plus 5 is the enharmonic, the same note as the flat 13, an A flat or a G sharp, but it's definitely another note. In a plus 5 chord, there's no 5 anymore because it's plus. And in a flat 6 or flat 13 chord, there is a 5 still. That's an A flat and a G together, but the G sharp and the G together are this not possible. So this is also an interesting note. No scale, sorry. Sharp 5. And then sharp 5. Right? How to fill in this gap? Maybe you can use the sharp 11 again. It's a whole tone scale. So when you have a C9 or C7 plus, you can play the whole tone scale. If it's actually a C9 flat 13, you can play whole tone or F minor melodic. And also the whole tone, like the octatonic scale, is not a scale that belongs to one tonality. So you can use that in different keys. And it's a very nice scale to play patterns again. For instance, thirds are nice. Or it's already nice. This is about the dominant chord in a major tonality. Right? This is the C7 in F. This is what you can do with it. Now we're going to talk about C7, the 5, the 5th degree in F minor. The first one is very simple. It's C7 flat 9 flat 13. And A flat is the flat 13. So if I keep it like that and I play a scale down, it's an F minor harmonic. The very basic scale that you play over the 5th degree in minor is minor harmonic. And of course you have to, you know, avoid the F or play the F on the upbeat and not on a downbeat because it sounds really bad. By the way, it doesn't sound bad because that's a matter of taste, but it changes the function of the dominant into a sus. And a sus, 7 suspended, is actually a subdominant. Right? So it's not about it sounds good or sounds bad. It changes the function and you don't want to have that. Also here, in order to get eight notes, you can play the chromatic. Oh, I play the E flat. It's not, not part of the scale yet. All right, let's talk about the E flat. In the tonality of F minor, there's an E flat, right? In the scale of F minor, the natural minor scale is an E flat. And in the chord, C7 has an E. Maybe it's good to combine it. There are also melodies who have an E and an E flat. An E and an E flat. Alright, this is getting interesting, because if you have a scale of F minor with an E and an E flat, there's a chromatic part in that scale, and there's no name for a normal scale with a chromatic part. F, E, E flat, what is that? So, when you play in minor, you can also check the major relative. In this case, it's A flat. Alright, I play the arpeggio. C7, flat 9, flat 10, flat 13. And when I put all those notes, including the flat 13, together, I get this scale. Right? There's a scale without an F, including an E and an E flat. So we cannot talk about the scale in F anymore because there's no F in the scale. So let's check the major relative A flat. A flat major harmonic. Of course major, because we play in the relative major key, A flat major. And the combination of notes is A flat major harmonic. I like this scale because all the notes are part of the tonality and part of the chord, the C7. There's no extra alteration, which is not part of the tonality, not yet. So this is C7, flat 9, flat 10, flat 13. Some people say sharp 9, it's fine. I say flat 10 because if you have a flat 9, it's hard to raise or lower the 9 in the same chord. And sharp C7, sharp 9 means that there's a D sharp in the chord, but there's no D sharp in F minor. So I don't understand sharp now. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So the scale A flat major harmonic. Now the last scale. Sometimes you have, like in the Night of Tunisia, you have C7, but the bass is playing the tritone, the G flat. Sharp 11, yeah, the tritone. So let's focus on C7 with this. Flat 9, flat 10, flat 13, sharp 11, that's C7 altered, that's the name, the simple name. So let's play that same scale of A flat major harmonic, and now we play, instead of a G, we play a G flat, which is, or the F sharp, which is the sharp 11. What's the name of this? Think about the relative, the major relative again, A flat major, melodic, major minor. Some people say C7 altered, play D flat minor melodic, which is the same scale. But I like to think about the relative major and start on an A flat. And that scale starting on an A flat is called A flat major minor or A flat major melodic. Scale, and also the A flat major harmonic is a very good scale to play instead of 8 notes, 6 notes. If you don't want to choose between the G or the G flat, you don't want to choose between C7 with a sharp 11 or without a sharp 11, you can skip both notes. So you get this. Etc. Right? So you don't have to play chromatics here, you can skip a note. Alright, so this is it. Now you can get rich and famous and beloved.